After 17 years of living together in separate rooms, Willie told Maisie it was time to quit, to split or go crazy. And she said to him, "You were never much of a man anyway, with your TV beer belly pot, which for a thousand lonely Sunday afternoons was the only thing that I ever got." He said she was constantly cleaning. She said she was clearing the gloom. He said she keeps clean what he's never seen. She don't let him enter her room. And they fought about the kids and the car and the cat and the television set, the bank account, the full amount of how much each would get. The neighbors passing by her saying, "I hate this man more than any other man in the world. I hate this man more than any other man in the world." The neighbors passing by heard him saying, "I hate this woman more than any other woman in the world. I hate this woman more than any other woman in the world." And they hated one another more than any other ones in the world. Now Willie was sober that day in the courtroom, in a suit coat that fit too tight, telling how she locked him out and made him sleep in the carport on a cold February night. She said he was brutal and any talk was futile, and she was afraid he'd beat her and the kids in some drunken fight. He said she was full of shit and she called him the son of a bitch, and the judge didn't know which was wrong and which was right. He put aside his Bible, hit the gavel on the table, and calming down a bit, he said, "Irreconcilable differences." That was it. It was dead. They said they hated one another more than any other ones in the world. On the day they were married, everybody hurried. She stayed out of school, floated down the aisle on a bridal smile to Elvis singing "Don't Be Cruel." When the ceremony was over, everybody gathered for a VFW affair. When she cut the cake, he said, "I got a speech to make," and he shouted out for everybody there. He said, "I love this woman more than any other woman in the world. I love this woman more than any other woman in the world." She reached over and touched his cheek and whispered in his ear. But everybody was listening, so everybody could hear her saying, "I love this man more than any other man in the world. I love this man." And they loved one another more than any other ones in the world. They loved one another more than any other ones in the world.